Hey everybody, Dr. Tim Turlip here. Welcome to another 3 minutes to Vitality. And we're gonna continue our discussion a little bit on omega-3 fatty acids and their importance. And supplementation is probably a really good idea for most of us because we don't get enough fish, which is really where you get most of that as well. So we wanna make sure that we look at supplementation, but really quality supplementation to actually elevate our omega-3s to a level that we need them to be at. And as you mentioned, we really need to focus on blood testing, which is really simple, really easy. Here at the office, we use a simple one. One little drop of blood is all we need to actually obtain that omega-3 index, which we really want at 8 to 12 is the optimal range. Average Americans are 4, a little less than 4, a little above 4 is the average American. So we really need to double that level and more to actually enjoy some of the health benefits like what we discussed in the last 3 minutes. But today I wanted to hit on another couple of studies which were really interesting. One was published in the British Medical Journal called BMJ. And it was published a couple of few years ago, but significant because they were looking at coronary heart disease, number one killer in the United States. And in the United States, we actually have about 125 per 100,000 people who will actually die from coronary heart disease. 700,000 plus people each and every year. So they looked at actually 6 total countries. And we're looking, that goes down. I'm gonna cheat and actually look at the names of the countries. So we had Germany, Norway, Spain, Japan, and Korea. And with each of those, when we looked at the omega-3 index, comparing those with those countries, our level was, again, as we mentioned, was right about 4. Germany's came in at just about 6. We saw Spain just a little under 8, Japan a little under 10, and Korea at about 12. And as we look at those, one of the things that we notice is that there's an inverse relationship to death from coronary heart disease. It literally, as we get up to the 8 and higher, we watch that the death rate significantly lower. So really important. And a couple of people asked after the last, I got a couple of emails that said, okay, what doses do I take? Well, there was another study that looked at that and to see exactly what dose we take will get us where we need to be. So they took a bunch of people. Some people got placebos and other people got different doses of 300, 600, 900, 1800 milligrams of DHA and EPA a day. Well, the average person started at 4.3, makes sense, because that's the average in America, right around that range. And the placebo group, of course, after the period of time of taking it, actually had no surprise, no change, right? Which is what we expected. The 600 milligram group actually, again, did not achieve the status of 8. Right, the 900 milligram dose of people actually achieved a level of 7.5. And again, we don't care what it's a percentage rating, and we discussed that last video, and get to 7.5. So 900 is really right there at the level where we need to be. The people at 1800 actually elevated to a level of 9.5%, which is really a strong, right, between that 8 and 12. So if you're taking 1,000 milligrams, 1 gram, of EPA and DHA, a really good source that we need to make sure they're very clean and is very potent. And is it gonna be a little bit more expensive? Because the quality is. We can find them much less expensive, but we don't get there. The doses are never enough and they aren't the quality. Many of them are rancid, many of them are polluted. So we wanna make sure that their quality and the dose, about 1,000 milligrams, will get most of us to that level of 8 and up. Some people will be need a little bit more, but again, the testing will tell us what needs to be done. So if you're someplace else, away from our facility, et cetera, another county, state, et cetera, that's what you wanna do is make sure you get it tested, try that dose, get tested again in 90 to 120 days, and if it's more or less, up it a little bit, 300 to 500 milligrams, and then get it tested again 3 to 4 months later, and you'll find your sweet spot. As you can tell by the research we've covered in the last couple, and there's oodles of it, it's critical. It's one of the most important things that we can do to our global well-being. So that's it for omega-3 fatty acids for today. Thanks for watching.